बुद्धस्स नमो तस्स भगवतो अरहतो सम्मा संबुद्धस्स नमो तस्स भगवतो अरहतो सम्मा संबुद्धस्स। गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। टुडे वी शैल बी कंटिन्यूइंग विद द सुपावासा सूत्र विच वी डिड लास्ट टाइम। Can you see the screen?
Yes, we can see the screen, but
So I think we did the Supavasa Sutta up to I think we translated
I think maybe you're sharing the wrong screen, Bande, because we see in your laptop screen.
Okay. You mean the desktop?
Yes, the desktop, yes.
How about now?
It's the same. Oh, yeah, it's good now, Bhante.
So I think we did up to Mahamoggallana talking to his devotee and also asking for whether he can guarantee his saddha, sorry, three things, the life, wealth and the faith. And Mahamoggallana guaranteed for his life and wealth. So then he gave the opportunity to Supavasa, the Upasaka, the lay devotee gave the opportunity to Supavasa to give the dana, to continue with the offering. So I think we did up to there. And in the commentary, in the commentary, Supavasa Sutta. Right. Also, we discussed about there were two opinions of the ancient commentary. They considered that Mahamoggallana didn't guarantee upon the lay devotee's faith because faith is something related to the mind and the person, it's the responsibility is with the person. But with regard to their life and wealth, he guaranteed that there isn't any harm going to happen to him for the future 7 days. So I think we discussed that point. This is Tathagata explanation. It's a long.
Bhante?
Yeah.
May I ask two questions regarding the things that we have discussed before, Bhante?
So it means, so shall we first finish the sutta and come into the 2 points? Is it okay?
It is related to the commentary that we have discussed before, Bhante. So my first question is like, the lay devotee, like for me, the impression that I get is that he is asking for some kind of prophecy, Bante. So is that an appropriate thing to do, Bante?
Yeah, it can be done. It's not a problem. Because if we know that he can see the future, so if we can ask him whether, well, how do you see about my future, so it is not an inappropriate thing.
But for the monk, how is it from the standpoint of Vinaya, Bante?
Vinaya is no problem. You can predict whatever you see. Only thing that you cannot say that I have that ability.
Oh, okay, Bhante.
You can say whatever they see, but they cannot claim that I am such a person.
Okay, Bhante. And Regarding the second question is regarding the two opinions, Bante. So like the second opinion, if I remember correctly, it's like the Buddha or know that he is the Tathāsacca, right, Bante? At least the Sotapanna level, Bante. So that his fate will surely exist even after 7 days, Bante. My question is like that. I don't think that it should be for someone to be an Arya, like for maybe even the Buddha already see that his fate will still exist after 7 days, but it doesn't mean that it has to be like an Arya that only able to do that one thing. Like maybe the Buddha already see that in 7 days he will still be the same, but it doesn't necessarily mean that he's an Arya, Bante. So, how about that, Bante?
That one shall we discuss after we do the translation for first time?
Because Bante.
It will lead to some discussion. So
okay, sure, Bante.
We'll discuss after, as soon as we finish the translation, I'll take that question.
Okay, Bante. Yes, sure, Bante. Thank you, Bante.
So I think we did up to here. Sancha Dharakam, yeah. So then what we have is to translate the last part of the sutta. It's not that much long. If someone can do the translation, I think from Attako Ayasma Mahamoggallan, from here till the end, someone can translate. So how about, because we have had nine participants constantly. So I think some of you have been very interested in translating. And how about some others who didn't translate this sutta? Anyone can try? Would someone like to try who didn't do the translation? Brother Robin, did you translate this sutta?
Not yet, Bante. But I'm stuck with the gatha, Bante.
Okay. Till gatha, you can translate till gatha.
Okay, Bante. I will try, Bante. Sanyapetwa.
Attako.
Attako ayasma ma mugalano tang upasangka upasakang sanyapetwa yena bagawa. Tenu pasangkabi. Sorry, Bante. The Sanyapetwa is convinced, right, Bante?
Yeah.
Then the Venerable Mahamoggallana, yes,
Bante? As we can have the translation, having made him known, Sanyapetwa.
Oh, having made him known. Okay.
But it seems like having made him known, so having convinced him, having got his consent, like such a context, right? Anyway.
Okay, Bante. Then the Venerable Mahamoggallana, having convinced that Upasaka, approached the Blessed One. Upasangka mitwa bagawantang etada wocha. Having approached, he said this to the Blessed One. Sanyato Bante so upasako maya. Karotu supawasa koliadita sakta batani. Pachaso karisatiti. Bante, the Upasaka has been convinced by me. The Supawasa, the daughter of Kolian, may do the seven meals. He will do afterwards. Attako Supawasa Koliadita Satahang Buddha Pamukang Bhikkhu Sangha Panitena Kadaniena Bojaniena Sahatta Santapesi Sampaware Sampawaresi tangca darakang bagawantang wanda pesi sabangca bikusangga. Then Supawasa, the daughter of Kolian, with her own hands, serve and delighting the bikusangga headed by the Buddha, with soft foot and rough foot. But is it correct, Bante?
Okay, okay.
Edible.
Yeah, is quite soft food. Khadaniya is quite hard. But it's not a very, according to Vinaya context, we have various interpretations on this. We can just translate hard food and rough food and soft food. It's not a problem, right?
Okay, Bante. So, served with her own hands, soft food and rough food for 7 days.
Rough food and soft food.
Rough food and soft food, Bante. Okay. Tangcak garakam bagawantang wanda pesik sabang cak piku sangga. Wanda pesi is broad, but not Bante.
Vandati is to pay respect. Vandapeti is to make him to pay respect.
Oh, yes. She made that boy to pay respect to the blessed one and all the Bhikkhu Sangha. Atako ayasma sariputto tangdarakang etada wocha. Then the Venerable Sariputta said this to that boy. Kacite daraka kamania, kaci yapania, kaci na kinci dukanti.
Kaci is just a questioning form. You don't need to translate it. Just put it. You can just put it as a question.
Oh, okay, Bante. And
How are you? Like how is it? Something like that.
You don't need to have. Sorry, Bante. Maybe I need to see the vocabs first. So, come on. I hope you are fine. I hope you are you fine? Are you well? I hope there are no whatever suffering. Is it okay, Bante?
Okay.
Kuto me Bante Sariputta kamaniya kuto yapaniya sata me wasani lohita kumbia utani ti. Kuto. How about the kuto in here, Bante?
We can have from where do I have any comfort, but also we can say how means how could I have some comfort because I have been living in Lohita Kumbiyang. Lohita Kumbiyang means in the mother's womb, so it's like. We can say blood pot. That's
not what I'm blood pot, yes.
So
the womb.
Pot. So we can say just in the womb. So I have been living for 7 years in the mother's womb. So how can I have comfort? From where do I get comfort? So it's like he's asking, how possible is it that I'll be comfortable? Something like that.
Okay, Bante. So maybe like Bante Sariputta, how could I be in comfort? How could I be well? For I have been staying at the womb for 7 years. Okay. Atako supawasa koliadita puto me damasena patina sading manteti ataman mantetiti atamana pamudita piti somana sa jata ahosi. Then Supawasa, the daughter of Kolian, thinking, my son is discussing with the the Dhammasena.
General of Dhamma.
The general of Dhamma. And then become pleased. Become happy, become delighted. Is it okay, Bante? Atako bagawa supawas supawasang kolia ditarang atamanam pemuditang piti somana tang widitwa supawasang kolia ditarang etada wocat. Then the blessed one, having known that the supawasa, the prince of Kolian, become happy, delighted, said this to Supawasa, the Kolian daughter. Icheya si tuang Supawase anyang pi ewa rupang putanti. Supawasa, do you wish to have another such kind of son? Is that okay, Bandi?
Yeah.
Icheya mahang bagawa anyang nipi ewa rupani sata putani. Blessed one, I wish to have another 7 such kind of sons.
Okay, sadhu. Thank you very much for the translation.
Thank you, Bante. Sorry for the bad translation, but
so I think everyone could understand the context. So what happened was Supavasa, now she got the opportunity to give the dana. So she gave the dana for 7 days. So then what happens, she was very interested, she was very delighted, and at the last day, the son was called Sivali, he was conversing with Venerable Sariputta, the general of Dhamma, foremost disciple of the Buddha. So she was very happy that her son was having a discussion with Venerable Sariputta. So she was very happy about it. Then the Buddha, having seen this, that she was very happy, asked a very nice question. Do you wish to have another such kind of a son? Evarupam Putta. So the commentary says that this Evarupam refers to a son, that she gave birth to a son having bared him for 7 years in the womb, and also having greatly suffered for 7 days with the complications in delivering. So do you wish to have such a son, another son? So her answer was, Icheya maham bhagava anyani pevarupani satta puttani. Bante, what about one son? I wish to have such 7 sons. So such 7 sons means, even I had to endure such pain for 7 years and 7 days. Again, for 7 times, I would be happy to have such sons, children. So that was her answer. So then the Buddha was, Buddha uttered a gatha. I'll just translate this. Atako bhagava etamattang viditva thayang velayang imam udana udana. Having known this meaning, the Buddha uttered this utterance. So there are asatang sata rupena piya rupena appiya dukkang sukasa rupena pamatta mati vattati. So the verb is ati vattati, pamattang ati vattati, overcomes the one who is negligent. What overcomes is asatang satarupena, what is undesirable in the appearance of a desirable thing. Piya rupena appiyang, one which is not very pleasant, dear, not very dear in the appearance of something very dear or pleasant. Dukkang sukasa rupena, the suffering in the appearance of happiness. Pamatta mativattati, overcomes the one who is negligent person. So he was talking this, telling this, referring to Supavasa, who was a Sotapanna already. So even she was not contemplating wisely on that occasion, because she wished to have 7 children, even though that bearing of such children was an immense suffering. It was a great suffering. But because of the love towards the child, she liked to bear that child. So that was the rough idea of this gatha. So we'll go into the translation. Atako ayasma mugalanu tangupasakan sanyapitva yena bhagavate. So then the blessed Maha Mugalana, having made him known whom the tangupasaka, that upasaka, yena bhagavate upasaka, approached the Buddha. Because we know the discussion, what happened with him. Upasankamitva, having approached Bhagavantan etadagocha. I think you can understand. Sanyato bhante su upasako maya. Bhante is vocative case. Sanyata is the verb. Sanyato maya so upasako. Sanyata is to make him know. Sanyapeti, or make someone convinced. So sanyata is a past participle. Convinced or made him known. So it's a passive voice verb. So the object should be written in active nominative. So upasako sanyato, that upasaka has been convinced, was convinced, or was made to know, So by me, maya. It's a passive voice sentence. Sanyato bante su upasako maya. Karoto suppavasa koli dita sattabatta. Suppavasa koli dita, the suppavasa, the daughter of Polians. Karotu sattabatthani karotu, may do seven meals, may mean offer seven meals. It means offer seven meals on 7 days. Paccha so karisati, so means upasaka. He will do later. He will offer the do the offerings later on. Right, that's what it refers here. Then Atako Supavasa Koli Dita, Sattaham Buddha Pamukam Bhikkhu Sangam Panitena Kadaniyena Bhojaniyena Sahatta Santappesi Sampavaris. Tancha Dharakam Bhagavantam Vanda Pesi Sabbanta Bhikkhu Sangam. So these are two sentences connected together. The verb of the first sentence is Sampavarisi. The second sentence verb is Vanda Pesi. Both are causative verbs. Sampavaresi. So normally, pavareti, it's like when we offer something or when we invite, that is called pavareti. And sometimes rejecting is called pavareti. So we have the pavarana, we have few meanings. And also another meaning is cause to accept, to offer, to regal, serve it. So normally, we just translate it as like offer, so to serve someone. Technically, there is a vinaya aspect here. It means, now when we reject something, that is called pavarana. Invitation is also pavarana, rejection is also pavarana. So now, there is a rejection of food mentioned in vinaya, that is while we are eating, some bhojaniya, some kind of food. If while we are eating, if someone happens to offer us, if that's enough, we would say enough. So then after we stand from that seat, we are unable to eat for that day. That is called pavarana rule. It's a rule that has to be followed. I'll repeat again, while we are eating rice, while we are eating something, if someone offers us rice, doesn't matter who offers, if you reject it, or if you say, if you just direct it, I don't need it, but why by whatever may. So for that day, after we stood from that seat, after we change the posture, we cannot eat for that day. It's a very strict rule for bhikkhunis. We monks have some opportunities to make, like to do some small vinayakama. Vinayakama means go to a monk and do some act and we can eat for that day again. But for bhikkhunis, the rule was very strict and there is no opportunity for them to eat again. So this was laid down because one time monks went for a dana and the lay devotee wanted to offer them more and more. Then they rejected and they went for pindapata and into their relatives and friends' houses. So a lot of food was left away. So the original donor asked the neighbors to come and eat because there was a lot of food was left. So the neighbors were some relatives and friends. So the neighbors told, how could you offer us? Because the monks who visited your house also visited our houses and had meals again. So it means there was not enough food for them. So the Upasaka was very, very upset about the incident. He said, I already offered them for the second, third times and they rejected. I had enough food to offer. How could they do such a thing? Because I invited them for my lunch and they rejected the food and went and ate in another house. So he was really offended by the incident. So when this was informed to the Buddha, Buddha mentioned, Buddha made a very strict rule that after we reject the food while we are eating, that's a scenario, not while we first, except for the first time, while we are eating our meal, if something is offered, there are a few types of food, not all the food, like rice, fish, meat, and so forth, five types of food. So if we reject the such food while we are eating such food, we are unable to eat again after we change the posture. So sampava resi, pava reti is we reject. Sampava resi means make someone to reject. It means, according to the Vinaya context, this shows that Buddha was having meals, Sangha was having meals, Upavasa was again and again offering. So as it was enough for them, the Sangha have rejected the food. So having rejected means they had enough food. They had enough food. So in that context, there is another explanation for this. Normally we translate that served the Sangha, offered the Sangha very well. But another way of explaining this in the Vinaya context, that is one kind of approach made in the commentaries. Sampavarezi means they made, the donor made the Sangha to reject, refuse the food. It means, it indicates implicitly that they had enough food, she or he had already served the Sangha very well, right? So we can have, we just go in for that she served, the simple translation. But I would like to remind that there is such a Vinaya explanation on this as well. So explanation related to Vinaya. So she served santapesi, make them satisfied, like enough food. They gave them enough food. So there is no gerund or infinitive in the sentence. It's one sentence. It's just one sentence entirely governed by the verb. Sahatta. Sahatta means, hatta is hand, saha means her own hand. Sahatta. So this is ablative case. This ablative case is in the meaning of instrumental. Ablative. P-I-V-E. In the instrumental meaning. So it's having offered with her hand. With her hand. But I think philologically we can have a ablative case in this R ending. So philologically it's a pure instrumental case. We can have instrumental in the R ending. So philologically it's an instrumental case. Traditionally we would say ablative in the instrumental meaning. So with the hand. So she supavasa koliya dita offered the sangha, satisfied the sangha with the hands. With what? Bhojaniyena, khadaniyena, hard food and soft food we can call. Bhojaniya there are five types of bhojaniya. We normally say rice, and there are another two types of food which are eaten in South Asia, like we normally, one kind made out of flour, like sometimes we call it fly in Sri Lanka, made out of flour, like one kind, like out of rice flour or bread flour, whatever. So, and also fish and meat. There are five types of bhojaniya. Khadaniya is the remaining, all the remaining food. All the remaining food. Or technically, khadaniya can refer to, there can vegetables. All the vegetables are khadaniya. So, sometimes khadaniya refers to hard food like the sweets and so forth. So, it's not a very good translation. Normally, we say hard food. Khadaniya means that something we break with our teeth. That is called khadaniya. But it's not a very accurate translation. So because according to the Vinaya, we have khadaniya and bhojaniya. We have specific explanations on this. So even we translate hard food and soft food, it is not a big issue. But if we go into the to explain this terminologies according to the Theravada tradition, it covers a huge range, especially this khadaniya. So with khadaniya and bhojaniya, with her hands. Maybe because now there are two instrumental cases here, to avoid a confusion, maybe they have got the a different case ending. Instead of using the sahattena, may they may have used the sahatta to reduce this like continuously three instrumental cases to show that this is with what she served with her own hands. This is the food she served. So how did she serve? So how did she make them satisfied with food with her hand? So this is like object. So if that was offered, diyati, danam, this would be in accusative case. Since the verb is to satisfy, to treat, so this has come in the instrumental case. Panitena, delightful. So it's an adjective of these two. So whom did they satisfy? Whom did they offer? The Bhikkhu Sangha. Bhikkhu Sangha. The Sangha. Buddha Pamukang, led by the Buddha. Then during which day? Sahatang. Sattahang. 7 days. Why it is in accusative case? Because continuously for 7 days. Continuously means she offered every day without any break. Sahatang. Sattahang. Buddha Pamukang. Bhikkhu Sangha. Panitena khadaniyena bhojaniyena sahatta santappesi sampavaresi. Atako suppavasa ko. Then the suppavasa koliya dita offered the Bhikkhu Sangha led by the Buddha 7 days continuously. Means every day she offered with the meal. Tancha dharakam. Bhagavantang vandapesi sabbancha Bhikkhu Sangha. And also, cha says, and also, tan dharakam, that boy. Bhagavantang vandapesi. Made that boy to pay respect to the blessed one, Pandapesi. Sabbhancha Bhikkhu Sangha. And also the entire Sangha. Like each and every monk who was present, she made him to pay respect. The commentary says the offering started after 11 days after the birth. So this incident happened at the end of the 7 days. So it means on his 18th day after the birth, this incident has happened. After the 18th day. Because first 11 days were for his after his birth, he spent 11 days, and on the starting from the 11th day, from 12th day, the offering, the dana happened. Atako asma Sariputto tandarakang etdu. Then while he was paying respect, or after he has paid respect, the Venerable Sariputta talked to that boy. Kachite daraka kamaniya. Do you feel like comfortable? Are you living with ease? Kachiyapaniya. Can you endure? Kachi na kinchi dukkanti. So isn't there any suffering for you? Is there any suffering? Na kinchi dukkam. Kuto me bhante sariputta kamaniya. How could it be that I am comfortable? Kamaniya or yapaniya. It's how could I remain like sustain without any discomfort? Sattame vassani lohita kumbiyang utani. I have been living in the mother's womb for 7 years, right? Have been living for 7 years. So how should I say that it is bearable, or it is that I have been living with comfort, with ease, because I have been just got delivered after 7 years living in the mother's womb, which is a very, very disturbing place. Then atako suppavasa koliya dita. Then the suppavasa koliya dita. Putto me dhamma sena dipatina sadhi mante titi attamana pamudita piti somana jata somana sajata ho. Atako then suppavasa koliya dita, the daughter of Kolian, attamana was happy, pamudita piti somana sajata ho. She was very happy, delightful, and piti and somanasa has occurred in her. So she was very happy. Why? What was the reason? This is what she thought. This was the reason. Putto me dhamma sena dipatina saddhim mantit. Putto me dhamma sena dipatina saddhim mantit. Verb is mantit. Subject is putta. Me putto, my son, converses or talks, discusses with whom? Dhamma sena dipatina saddhim, together with the general of dhamma, Venerable Sariputta. Atako bhagava. Suppavasam koliya dhitaram etada vocha. Then the blessed one, these are within brackets. Suppavasam koliya dhitaram. The koliya, the son, daughter of Kolian, Suppavasa, said this to her. Right? So within the bracket it says, First, the blessed one knows having viditva, having known viditva, suppavasang koliya ditarang attamanang pamuditang piti so manasa jatang. Having known that suppavasa was delighted, said this to her. Icchayasi tvam suppavase anyampi evarupam puttanti. Suppavase is vocative case. Icchay tvam icchayasi. Do you wish? Icchayasi. Do you wish? It's a question. Anyampi eva rupam puttam. Another such kind of a son. Icchayam aham bhagava. Bhagava is vocative case. Icchayami aham. Icchayami aham. It's a sandhi. I do wish for. Anyampi eva rupani. Anyanipi eva rupani. Sattaputani. I wish for seven sons. Such seven sons. So normally the putta is a masculine gender noun. But here it has been used in the feminine, neuter gender. So the comment to say it was a linga vipallasa, change of gender. So it should have been said that anye eva rupe satta putte. Instead of that, anyanipi eva rupani satta putta. Atako bhagava etamattang viditva thayang velayang imam udana udana. So then the blessed one, having known this meaning, uttered this utterance. So we'll go to the attakata for that. Etamattang viditva. So etamatta viditva, having known this meaning, Buddha said this. So etamattang viditva ti. Etang, so what he knew was etang satta divasadikani satta samvacharani gabba dharana divasena pavattang mahantang dukkang ekapade visaritva. Putta lolata vasena thaya buttamattang viditva. Having known what? Having known this buttamattang. Buttang means said. Buttamattang. The meaning of what has been said. Thaya buttamattang. By her. Having known what she has said. Just give me one moment. So then so here she having known Buddha knew got to know got understood the meaning said by her putta lolata vasena. Lola means like a desire, greed, like she was like well wishing for, longing, or she was very greedy of children, right? Putta lolata vasena, in terms of the greed towards sons. So she said this, having known what she said in terms of her greed towards sons. Ekapade visaritva. 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 Visaritva means having forgotten. Sarati is to remember. Visarati is to forget. Ekapade visaritva. So this one is normally, traditionally, we get the idea. Ekapade visaritva means ekapada. Pada is here, comes from the step. Pada. Pada vitihara. Pada is foot. Pada is a step. So ekapade means she forgot everything with one step. It's one kind of a usage. Like in Sri Lanka also, we have that usage in Sinhalese language. Ekapayin, like someone had some encounters for a long period, but they could forget it. Whether it is something tormenting or blissful, whatever it is, they tend to forget it with one step. It means they quickly forget this. So it's one kind of cultural usage. Like they forget it with one step. Like they don't want, they easily, if someone can give up enmity towards someone. So we can say he gave up with one step. In one step. Having kept one step, he or she gave up, forget whatever happened. So this is that is what he mean by ekapade visaritva. It's one kind of a usage in these cultures. So having forget it with one step, in one step, what did she forget? Mahantan dukkan, the great suffering, avattan, which happened, existed. In what means? Gabba dharana divasena. In terms of holding the, bearing the fetus or the child. How long? Satta samvatsaran. Satta divasa adhikani satta samvatsaran. Satta divasa is 7 days, adhika is more. So 7 years with more 7 days. Satta divasa adhikani satta samvatsaran. So etang satta divasa adhikani satta samvatsarani gabba dharana divasena pavattang mahantan dukkam ekapade vistaritva. So having forgotten that great suffering, that etang avattang mahantan dukkam, that great suffering which lasted for 7 years and 7 days because of holding bearing a child in the womb, she forgot it. Why did she forget it? Putta lolata vasena. Having forgot, putta lolata vasena taya buttattang viditva. So she said that she likes to have 7 sons. So having known that meaning, which she said, because of her greediness or liking, longing to children. So she forgot it in one step and she said this with the greediness to her children. Imang udananti, this utterance. Imang chitta sukha pamatto viya. Pamatta puggale ittakarena vanchitva tanha sinehasa. Mahanta Mahanattakara Bhava Deepakam Udanam Udanes. So he uttered this utterance, Udanam Udanes. Mahanattakara Bhava Deepakam. Deepakam means which illustrates. Mahanattakara Bhava. Anatta means disadvantages or dangers. Anatta. Anattakara. Anattakara means something which brings or something which causes disadvantages. Mahanattakara, great disadvantage. Mahanattakara bhava, the nature of causing disadvantages. Of whom? Of the tanha sinehasa, the desire and the love sinehasa. Tanha sinehasa, mahanattakara bhava deepaka udanam udanis. Utter this utterance which illustrates the nature of causing great disadvantages of tanha sineha, of love and craving. How? Vanchitva. Vanchitva means having deceived. Right? Having deceived. So this vanchitva is the imang of tanha. So if like the craving deceives the person. So this vanchitva is not connected to blessed one, because this utterance was uttered by blessed one. Normally the jaran should be connected to the subject, but here it's not so. So ittakarena vanchitva. Ittakarena vanchitva. In terms of ittakarena means in the appearance of a desirable thing. Pamatta pugale vanchitva. Pamatta pugale means pamatta is negligent person, puggale vanchitva. The people who are negligent, having deceived people who are negligent in the appearance of a pleasant thing. So chitta sukha pamatto viya pamatta puggale ittakarena vanchitva. So chitta sukha pamatto means a person, pamatta is a negligent person. Chitta sukha pamattu, one who is negligent because of the happiness in the mind. Some people may feel that this samsara is very good, very nice, because they have happiness in their mind. Chitta sukha pamattu viya pamatta puggale ittakarena vanchitva. So a person who is negligent in terms of happiness in the mind. So in such may be, right? Imang chitta sukha pamatto be Amatta Pugalene Pugale Ittakari in a Vanchetva, Tanha Sinihasa, Mahanatakara Bhava Deepakam Udana Udani. So she uttered the utterance which indicates the nature of craving, nature of bringing great disadvantages of craving, how having disconceived the negligent person in the appearance of a pleasant thing. Chitta sukha pamatto viya. So a person who is having happiness in the mind is conceived or is deceived by this happiness because of his ignorance and all these. So the happiness, the real happiness, deceives the person, and he starts to think that he is in bliss, though he is supposed to encounter a lot of suffering in samsara. So in the same way, imang pamatta puggale ittakarena manchitva tanha sinehasya mahanantakara bhava deepakam udana udana. So this utterance, which this imang is connected to mahanantakara bhava deepakam udana. So he uttered this utterance which indicates the nature of the sineha, tanha, of bringing great disadvantages, having deceived the person, negligent person, ittakare. Like it seems the tanha appears something very pleasant, very desirable. Or at the same time, we can also consider this tanha causes an object which is suffering to be desirable. So tanha, normally because of tanha, the objects which are undesirable, we consider it as desirable. So because the son, such a son, having such a son means we have the lady has to encounter lots of suffering for 7 years, unbearable suffering. So but still the tanha deceived the person and shows that this object is a pleasant thing. So that's what the Buddha wanted to mention, that the danger of this tanha and sineha, because it deceives the person and makes him to think an unpleasant object, truly unpleasant object, as pleasant, and also an undesirable object as desirable. So this is what the meaning of this this verse. Now he knew that she forgot every suffering with one step, and then she said that she would prefer to have a lot of 7 more children. And then knowing this, Buddha mentions that this is the nature of tanha, that it deceives the person and made them to believe that these objects are very desirable, though they are not in reality. So they are not in reality. So then we conclude the sutta with this gatha. This is the gatha we have. Asatan sata rupena piya rupena apyang dukkang sukasa rupena pamattang ativattati. So ativattati is the verb, right? Ativattati is the verb. So what does it overcomes? Normally we translate ativattati passes over, goes beyond. Ativattati. Pamattam. One who is negligent. Pamattam ativattati. What is the subject of this ativattati? 3 subjects. Asatam, apyam, dukkham. Right? Asatam, apyam, dukkham. Asatang in the asatang, one is disagreeable, apyang, something not dear, unpleasant, dukkang is suffering. Right? We know that. So the disagreeable thing overcomes the negligent person in the appearance of a satarupe. In the appearance of something agreeable. disagreeable thing overcomes the person in the appearance. Rupa is in the appearance. Rupena, in the appearance of an agreeable thing. Appiyang, not dear thing, something unpleasant goes over the negligent person, peer rupena, in the appearance of a desirable or in the appearance of a pleasant thing, peer rupena. Dukkang sukhasya rupena. Suffering in the appearance of happiness. In the appearance of happiness. So this is, now we can see, sata rupa, peer rupa, sukha rupa. Instead of saying sukha rupa, sukhasya rupa. So here the samasa was not made. Sukhasya rupena. If we make the samasa, break the samasa here, here also we get piyasa rupena. If you want to break the samasa. Here also satasya rupena. In the appearance of a agreeable thing. So if you want to break the samasa. So when we have this piyasa rupa, sata rupa and so forth, it is normally connected with the samasa is made with the genitive case, right? So this is how we understand the gatha. Understand the gatha. Yeah. I will conclude now on my text. Reading 5. So, yeah. So here it says, asat, tatta asatanti, amadurang, asadurang, asundarang, anitta, something is very, very unpleasant. Satarupena, itta sabhave, in the appearance of, in the nature of a pleasant thing. Piyarupena, ati piya, piyai tabba bhave, in the appearance of something that should be considered as dear. Sukhasarupena, ati sukha sabhave, in the appearance of happiness. Idang uttang hoti. This is what the Buddha wanted to mention. Yasma asatang apyang dukkameva samanam sakalampi vattagatam sankhara jatam appahina vipallasattha ayoniso manasikaran ittam liya piyang liya sukang liya chukutva upatta manam sativippavasena pamatta puggalam ativartati abhibhavati ajyotarati. So yasma, because asatang appiyang dukkameva samana. Asatang appiyang dukkameva samana. This undesirable, unpleasant thing that is which is a suffering, which is a suffering. Sakalampi vattagata. All that belongs to the samsara world. Vattagata sankhara jata. All that conditioned things that belong to the samsara. Appahina vipallasatta. Vipallasatta. Because the hallucination, vipallasa, has not been eradicated. This is the reason. Appahina vipallasattha. Ayonuso manasikaran, because of unwise attention. Ittang viya, piyang viya, sukang viya, chaputva, upattahamanam. So because of our ayonuso manasikara, and since we have not eradicated the vipallasa, these appiya, asata appiya dukkha appears to us upattamana ittang viya as pleasant, as dear or as happiness upattamana satya vipavasena amatta puggalam upattamana satya vipavasena because of the absence of sati amatta puggalam ativattati abhibhavati ajyotarati overcomes the negligent person, overcomes completely, goes beyond, drowns the negligent person. Tasma, therefore, imampi suppavasam punapi sattakattung evarupam asatam apyam dukkam satadipatirupakena satadipatirupakena dukkena putta sankhata pema vattu sukena ajyotara. The same way, tasma, therefore, imampi suppavasam, also this suppavasa lady, punapi again sattakattung for 7 times evarupang asatang appyan dukkha. Such undesirable suffering object, the sun, Satadi Patiru Pakena. Satadi Patiru. Sata here means object opposite of Asata. Sata Asatadi Patirupake. Asatadi Patirupakena. Patirupaka means something in the appearance of something, but not truly. Patirupaka. Patirupaka means it's similar. Satadi Rupa and Satadi Patirupa. So Satadi Rupa means in the appearance of something which is agreeable, but it's not really agreeable. When we say Patirupaka, it directly says that it is not an agreeable thing. It is in the agreeable appearance, but not really agreeable. Dukkena Satadi Patirupakena Dukkena. Putta Sankhata Pema Vattu Sukena. Putta Sankhata Pema Vattu Sukena. Sukha, happiness in the object Vattu Sukena. Putta Sankhata Pema Vattu Sukena. So it's a happiness that arose based on the suns, based on the suns, right? Putta Sankhata. Putta Sankhata means we call the Putta. So rough idea is that that suffering Satadi Rupakena Dukkena Putta Sankhata Pema Vattu Sukena Ajyotarati. So Vattu Sukena. It is actually this Vattu Sukha means there are two types of Sukha. So the Sukha which appears in our mind is the real Sukha. And then another Sukha is the object. Object is also can be said Sukha. There are a few meanings of Sukha. You can find this in, if you want this, some information on this, please go to Dhamma Sangani. Dukam Atikamatika. Vedanatika. There are various meanings of Sukha. So one is the object, right? One is the object. So here also, the Sukha, in this case, Sukha means the sun, the object. So this really undesirable object, which is a sun, overcomes this Suppavasa in the appearance of a very pleasant thing, right? That's what the Buddha wanted to say. So undesirable objects appear to us as desirable and overcomes us because it is because of our negligence, because of our delusion, right? Delusion. So that is what the Sutta says. So yeah, I think I explained a lot about this. So yeah. So in the end, Buddha wanted to mention that beings, because of their negligence, happen to accept things that are not really, consider things that are not really blissful as blissful. Yeah, we can have a discussion on this.
Yeah, hi Pante. Yeah, I have a, so yeah, could you please go back to the sutta?
Sutta, okay.
Yeah. So I have a question about the word sangbawareti. So as you explained, Pante, sangbawareti, it's the causative verb, right? So here, the object of it is the bhikkhu sangha, right? Bhikkhu sangha. But it looks to me that because it's a causative verb, so it needs two objects, right? So it caused the sangha to reject something. So does that mean that if we write this sentence completely, or I mean, you know, in detail, then we would need to have the khadaniya and bojaniya in front of the sambhavaresi, right, Pante?
Okay.
So that means we need to have those two words in the accusative case as well, in front of the word sambhavaresi.
Yes, we can. Yeah, okay. Positive verb, yeah.
Right. Yeah, and then okay, Pante, thank you. And the other question is about the word lohita kumbiyang. So is lohita kumbi is a kind of hell, Pante?
That is loha kumbi.
Loha kumbi.
Yeah. Loha kumbi and lohita kumbi.
Oh, I see.
Kohakumbhi is because that hell is in a metal pot where lot of hot liquid is. So that's where the Ajatasattu was born in Lohakumbhi. So it's different, like referring to the womb.
I see. Okay, Pante. And then the other question is about the, could you please go to the Attakatha, the word one jetoa.
Right, okay. Yeah, okay.
Yes. So here, so it looks like the subject of that verb is tanha sineha, right, Pante?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, so I really have problem with this. I mean, why didn't he write it in, you know, like the past participle or present participle, but he wrote it in the gerund?
It's
very
right?
Confusing, yes.
I think, to be true, if I frankly say, this we found this kind of many usage in this commentary, right?
Yes, Pante.
So this is also something new for me. I didn't find much that kind of usage in other commentaries. When I read the Anguttara Majjhima commentary and other commentaries, I don't find these kind of little bit strange usages. So I was also getting an idea why this Udana commentary, and also if you go into the Itivuttaka commentary, has these kind of little bit difficult usages to understand, which seems like strange grammar. So they both were written by Venerable Dhammapala, not Buddha Ghosa. This is not Buddha Ghosa, this is Dhammapala. So I find this, as you said, that this kind of, we have idea, why didn't he use that word instead of this? So I'm unable to give a direct answer to this. I also was a little bit confused. Why did he use such confusing types of sentences in these two commentaries?
Right. Yeah, because otherwise, if it's a past participle, then we just, you know, it's the same case of the next word, then it's very clear, yeah.
Very easily.
Yeah.
Correct.
Okay, thank you, Pante. And then I have another question, but maybe after Robin. Please, because...
Dr. Ryan, if you could please, because I didn't have time to do that, if you could mark such places that we found was very strange, because we experience a few places here, right? In such
right,
cases.
Right. Okay. Yeah.
If we can collect them, we can do some research or some idea about why this is different from other commentaries.
Sure, Pante. Yeah, I'll do that, Pante. Thank you, Pante. Yeah. And then, yeah, another question is related to Robin's question. So maybe you answer Robin's question first and I'll ask that next question. Oh. Okay, thank you, Pante.
So before we go into Brother Robin's question, is there any grammatical or any direct questions related to our Sutta translation?
Oh, so
Bande.
Yeah, hello?
Yes,
yeah. Okay. Yeah. So Bande here. Kuto Yapaniyam here, how can we translate?
Kuto Yapaniyam, right?
Yeah.
So this one, you can see, where is that? Yeah. Kuto me Yapaniyam. So you can find this word, Chale. Now, when someone said that there is, like someone is going to pass away, someone has passed away, Buddha said, the Venerable Ananda was unhappy, sad about the Buddha's parinibbana. So Buddha said, "Kuto tvang," from where you find something, from where you wish something to be permanent, which is conditioned. So this is the usage they use. So normally, kuto is from where, right? Normally it's from where. But at the same time, we know that to suffix can be used in many meanings. Instrumental, ablative, locative, we can have many meanings. So we can have, where is any happiness for me? Where is any comfort? From where do I get comfort? How can I have comfort? So all these translations are possible. All these translations are possible grammatically. So this has been one kind of, how do you call that, cultural usages. like way of saying. So it's very difficult to give an exact grammatical explanation. We can have few, when we put it into a language like English, where can I be, can I have such happiness? From where do I get such happiness? How could I be happy? So all these translations are possible in this context.
Okay, thank you, Danny. Another one is like when we say
more thing to clear. So in English, can we say that now when we say from where can I get such a happiness? Is it a usage in English? Like, can we use such a usage?
Yes, of course, Pante.
Can, right?
Yes, we can, Pante.
But can we explain it grammatically, or is it just a that you get the meaning only?
No, I mean it's very common usage, Pante. I mean, so when you say from where do you get that, then it's like a very formal English.
Formal English.
Yes, it's okay. Formal because normally we say where do you get it from.
But okay.
In for the people who have, you can say, you know, very educated, and they would say from where you get.
Okay.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Right. Thank you for that. Yes, Sally.
And also another one is like when we say Iwa Rubani Sadaputani here in the commentary, this it mentions Linga Vibhanasa, right? Mm-hmm. And commentary mentions Linga Vibhanasa. But according to philology, the philology they would say is like a Magadhi form.
Okay. That's good information. So putta
Tani, like this type.
Some puttani in Magadhi, no?
Yeah, it's a Magadhi form. Accusative plural.
Which gender?
Masculine gender.
So in Magadhi there is a
yes. this we also have Damani.
Right, Damani. Okay.
And sometimes very rare to use as a nominative plural as well.
Damani. Thank you for that.
This is, you can check the Gaiga paragraph 76.
Very rarely. Accusative plural, nominative plural.
Nominative plural, yes.
Gaiga?
Yeah, Gaiga, paragraph 76.
Para 76.
And obelisk also. Obelisk is 30.
Obelisk, I don't know how to say it.
LIS
76.
No, 30.
Right. Thank you for that. Because we sometimes find Rukhani also, right?
Yes. Actually, there are many places we can find the ani form in the masculine gender. So they said this is the real Magadhi form, the Magadhism.
Yeah, we find another word for Rukhani also. Yeah, it's a very common thing, right? Mm. Thank you for that. Yeah.
Yeah, because generally we know actually Bali is the Western form, right?
Yeah.
And in the Suttas we found some like a Eastern form. Eastern form we call like a Magadhism.
Okay.
That's right.
Thank you for that. So any other questions regarding the grammar before we go into that question? Okay. So we'll go into the Attakatha. This question, right? केरोपि तस्य दिव तेषु दिवसेषु भोजनं भोगानां जीवितस्य अनुपद्मं पश्यत्वा आह बिकॉज़ वी नो द उपासक आस्क्ड इफ यू कैन गारंटी माय सद्दा What else? Saddha, life, and wealth. I would allow Supavasa to give. Vinnanko nesang auso dhammanam patibodhi. Bojana to do this. I can guarantee for two things. Jivita and wealth. Saddha panasya chitta patibaddhati tasya bharankaram. So saddhaya pana tanyaya patibodhi. It's you, the one who has to be guaranteed for your faith. So commentary said, ancient commentary, saddha panasa chitta patibaddha. It's connected to his mind. Tasya bharankaram. It was given to, the responsibility was given to him. So then there's another explanation, or apicha so, but still, now this is an additional thing. So upasako ditta satyo, that upasaka was a sotapanna. How do we get the information? I have no idea. Tassa saddhaya anyata bhavo natiti tata utta. Because it was said, this statement, the commentators are insisting, because of this statement, we can have an idea that he was not a noble being. He was a noble being. That's why it was said. Tene vacha karaneena bhagavata. This is the reason why the blessed ones say, pachabhitvam karisatiti sanyati. So he said, when Buddha said that may he do it later. If the Buddha knew that there was such a possibility that he could have had not had he could have lost the faith, Buddha would have not done it. That's the argument. The Upasaka also, because of his he was got respect towards the Buddha and the Sangha, Buddha and the Thera. He accepted that. He said, okay, I'll do it later. So the question that comes is, now the question comes, did the Buddha, was it necessary that that person has to be a sotapanna? Couldn't the, if even if he was not a sotapanna, couldn't the Buddha see that his faith is not going to, he's not going to lose his faith? That is a one question that Robin asked. That's the main question. Brother Robin asked. So now another counter question that one can raise. If he was a sotapanna, why did he ask this question? If he was a sotapanna, he would have asked only, can you guarantee my life and wealth? He doesn't need to ask for a guarantee about his faith.
Yes, Bante, exactly. Bante.
Right? He knows that. It's impossible that I lose faith upon Buddha. That's another question that we can ask. So it showed that the original sentence showed, and this ancient commentary suggests, I think this ancient commentary suggestion was very, very accurate. I prefer it more. In first place, why did he ask this question? So Mahamoggallana, why did Mahamoggallana said, it's up to you? He would have said, no, you such a person. There are places that Buddha have mentioned. He went up to Mahanama Sakya. He asked, what would be my destination? No, you are surely going to the heavens. So he would have easily said, your fate is not going to change. That's something a natural phenomenon. But the answer was given, it's up to you. So it shows, it seems, he was not a sotapanna, and Mahamoggallana gave the responsibility to the person himself. Then that is the one thing that we have to think. I'm not concluding it, I'm just saying the opinions. That's how I personally would think. Then the next question comes, even if he was a putujjana, couldn't the Buddha see that he was not going to lose his faith? This, if the Buddha could see so, now this comes with the Buddha's omniscient wisdom, sabbanyuta jnana. Sabbanyuta jnana, that he could see past, present, and future. All past, present, and future. Sabbang jana. Sabbang jana. Sabbang means all. Now, past, knowing all the past makes sense because it has already happened. Knowing the present means what is happening at the moment. If his wisdom is so sharp, yeah, it's possible to know. It's a matter of fact whether his wisdom is able to see something very far or closer, because the wisdom loses its capacity with the defilement. So even the vasana is completely removed. So Buddha has no obstructions for his wisdom. So that's why he has 100% efficacy in his wisdom. So we believe that he was able to see everything. So what about the future? Can he see the future countlessly, immensely, like without any limitation? So if he can see the future countlessly, limitlessly, it means automatically he comes into the if future can be seen with the indeterminate time. How do you call it? Indeterminate. Undetermined, right? How do you call it? Like without any limitation. Okay, it can be seen without a limitation. Without a limitation. What happens? It's a very obvious fact, without any argument, the future is determined. So because if Buddha's wisdom is so accurate, if he can see everything in the future, and if his vision is not going to change, if he's going to see it as it is, you cannot change it. So it's already been determined. So can he see what is going to happen now? Can he decide that what is my next rebirth? Like how much I put effort, I'll be ending in such a place. Or that he knows that even knowing this determined nature, if I put effort, that effort is also already determined. So can he see each and every incident that is going to happen in future? So what happens is we fall into our destination, our liberation has already been determined. So this is a very dangerous thing. Personally, I feel that if he can see everything in future as it is, regardless of any limitation of time, everything has already been determined now already. So that's the argument that we have in Western philosophy, omnisciency of the God. Omnisciency and omnipotency. If the God is omnipotent, capable of everything, doing anything, and also he's omniscient, he can see everything, it's a contradiction. Because if he sees that someone is going to die in 100 years or 50 years, he cannot change it, then he's not omnipotent. Because there is a thing that he cannot change. What he has seen, he cannot change. So omniscience and omnipotence, omniscience and omnipotency cannot exist together. So likewise, if we say Buddha Sabbanyuta Jnana has limitless amount of looking into future, ability in looking into future, we come into the idea of determinism. It means our future has already been determined. Even the Buddha sees or not, if he is capable of seeing, it means it has been already determined. So then what does the text say? Is Buddhism already determined or not? That is a very huge thing to decide. There have been prophecies. I don't know how to pronounce it. Prophecy. Can anyone help me?
P-R-O-P-E-S-I-S. Prophecy, why?
Yeah. C-Y, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Prophecy. So if the things where he has prophesied, now we see in the Korakattiya Sutta, in the Sunakatta Sutta, Korakattiya, if you type this word, Buddha mentioned that this person is going to die in 7 days. In the incidence of Super Buddha, the father of Yasodhara, he prophesied that this is going to happen. But in some cases, like in the Vasakara, who accused the Arahant, he said, if he doesn't, if he do not ask for forgiveness, and with Ajatasattu, had he not killed his father, he would be a Paccheka, he would have attained Sotapanna. Now he is going to attain a Paccheka Buddha. The reason is, according to the sub-commentary of the Digha Nikaya, sub-commentary, the teachers would suggest that Paccheka Buddhas are twofold, the destined Paccheka Buddhas and non-destined Paccheka Buddhas. The non-destined Paccheka Buddhas, if the things have been fulfilled, they may attain Arahanthood in a Buddha Sasana. It's a possibility is there. Ajatasattu was such a person. Then, after his all practices, and he became, because he, his attainments was hindered, so now he is not going to have opportunity to attain Sotapannahood during this Sasana. So now, because of his wisdom, the accumulation of merits, he will be a Paccheka Buddha in future. So Ajatasattu's case, and also the Rajagahasetti, the rich merchant who ended up being a beggar, Buddha mentioned, had he done this and this, if it was already determined, because if the Buddha could see from the at the moment of Rajagahasetti's birth that this person is going to end up in as a beggar, Buddha could not have said that if he had tried. Yes, one can argue that he had the potency, so he mentioned, but actually what has happened is, if the Buddha saw that this person would end up being a beggar, what is the possibility? Why did the Buddha say that he, because it was already determined, Buddha knew that he would end up in, as a beggar. So these kind of sayings suggest that Buddha would prophesy something when it becomes determined, not always. In other cases, there is a probability that this and this both could happen. There is a much probability for some cases. So Buddha would know if there is a possibility, high probability that he would attain these positions. But still, there is some percentage that this person may not attain. So that's why early Buddhas didn't prophesy the Bodhisattva. Only the Dipankara Buddha did this. Couldn't other Buddhas see that he was a Bodhisattva? Couldn't other Buddhas see that he would get prophesied in the Dipankara Bodhisattva's feet? They saw it is very likely possible, but there was some, still there was a chance that he could have changed. So that's personally what I feel. That's why they did not prophesize him, even though they met him. He met them. So now, then the question comes, there are contradictions for what I'm saying. According to the tradition, it seems, when you come into the commentarial tradition, there are information saying that his wisdom in the future can see limitlessly. There are statements in the literature. At the same time, we find some information about determined and non-determined beings for the attainment. This is also found in the commentary. Sometimes it says he can see, look into the future. There is no statement that directly says that Buddha's wisdom to look into future is limited. It never says. There is no such a, I haven't come through. I don't think there is such a statement in the commentary literature that Buddha can see the future to some extent, that he may see the possibilities in some context. So, but at the same time, we also appreciate that there are determined beings, non-determined incidents. And we also emphasize about the wisdom, the Sabbanyuta wisdom, which can see all what is happening in present and future. So this, what I'm saying is that there is a future, there is a possibility of predicting or seeing the future, but sometimes he may see this is what is most likely to happen, and there is such some other, there could be such change in future. So does it contradict with the Sabbanyuta Jnana? I think no, because Sabbanyuta means he sees the future. So seeing all the possibilities in future is his Sabbanyuta Jnana. So because things have not been determined, he knows that all the two possibilities could happen. So that is his omniscience. Since when he starts to see it as determined? In some cases, when some conditions have gathered, he could say, surely this person is going to attain now. But before that, these causes have gathered, he could not have seen. Now, if you think like couldn't he see the causes of those causes, causes of those causes? So likewise, we can come behind and someone can ask the question. So from where cannot, from which point that he cannot predict, from which point he cannot predict? I personally think that is because of the mind. Chitta and Chetasika. Chitta and Chetasika means, now we normally say all Chitta and Chetasikas are based on causes, condition. That is for the, this is how I personally look into the doctrine. Condition, for the arising of Chitta, there should be condition for Chetasikas, for the Rupa. There is no doubt in it. So everything is condition. But not if you take about the decision we make. If we say to say that all the decisions are conditioned, decisions are conditioned. There is no free will. If decisions are conditioned, we lose the ability of free will. That we are unable to make a decision because all our decisions have already been determined based on the conditions. So personally, my personal view, these are purely personal, that there is a possibility of inhibition. Every action is possible to inhibit. That there was a possibility that the person could have not done the action. Otherwise, it's no use that the Buddha rebuke, accuse a person for an act he has done, for a wrongdoing he has done. Personally, I feel the philosophy behind rebuking, complaining is that if the Buddha knew that this is going to happen, that he himself, the person he couldn't control because there's no self, all the conditions have made him to do such a thing. So there's no fault because he didn't do any fault. He happened to do something. So there should be some ability of a person to inhibit the action, whatever action he's supposed to do. But in some cases, if we have crossed certain amount of kilesas, surely now he would be able to say, now after, for example, a monk visiting someone or a lady or something, now if the monk have crossed that line, now it's the kilesas are very strong, it's impossible that he could stop. He would end up doing a wrongdoing. So after he crossed a certain amount of kilesas, the level of kilesas, sometimes he may lose his control. But before that, there was always a possibility or probability or he had the capacity to stop himself. So what I'm saying is this inhibition suggests that the mind has an ability to make decisions by its own. But those decisions are very much conditioned by the past conditions, but not completely. Not completely. That people do make choices on that moment, but it's like, I would say, like, what is the probability for such a choice? There are many conditions. Now, for instance, a Buddhist, if someone starts to come and shoot a Buddhist, there are many possibilities. He could have hit him, he could have run, he could have accepted death, and he could have cried, and also he could have accepted death with the intention to be born in a good place. So he would start to practice loving kindness or start meditation and to face his death. A person, atheist, who doesn't believe in rebirth could also have all these choices. He could fight, he could run away, he could accept the death, he could cry, but there is no possibility. It's not possible that he would prepare himself for the death for the next life. So that choice, he doesn't have that choice. Why is that? Because there was no such conditions for such a choice. So choices are also made based on conditions. But which choice we make, I personally think, is something that we make on that position, on that moment. Otherwise, what happens, things become determined and there's no way out, no way that we can change our destiny. It means all destiny. So that's why I directly plunge into the deep question here. Because the question was asked, couldn't the Buddha prophesy, even being a Putujana, couldn't he say that he will not lose his faith? Personally, I feel there are limitations of even of a Buddha to prophesize the future. That he would say, if there is a high possibility that he may not lose the faith, but there is still there is a possibility. So that is my personal view. I'm not saying that this is a perfect hypothesis to avoid the determinism. This is how I look into the Buddha's omniscient wisdom and the abilities to look into future. Yeah, I know this will lead to a good discussion. Yeah, we can take a few minutes. Yeah, unfortunately. Yeah.
Thank you very much, Bhante, for the deep explanation, Bhante. But actually, what I mean previously is that, like, the second opinion of the commentator, they base it from the saying of the Buddha previously, like Bhante. So, the Paccapituang Karisatiksanya Pehi. So, like, they think that the Buddha would not say this if he is not sure that he will lose his faith, Bhante. So then the commentator conclude that by this saying, this upasaka is the sotapanna, Bhante. That is right, that right, Bhante?
Yeah, that's what they conclude.
Yes. So, but I don't think that this is like very strong evidence to suggest that he is a sotapanna because of that. Because, like, I think that it is also possible that Buddha, even though he is a putujana, he still sees that he will not lose his faith. Like, if I think that's, I personally
think the Buddha can see such a thing.
Yeah,
if he's a putujana, I think Buddha knows that his faith can change.
But maybe for this person that he can endure it for 7 days. So the Buddha still see no problem like that, Bhante.
He may see there's a high probability that he may not lose. I would say like that.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Because he is not seeing the fixed things, right, Bhante?
There's a high probability that he may not feel, not lose.
Oh, okay, Bhante. And also, Bhante, the other point is that maybe, like, if this person is a sotapanna, then there is high probability that the Bhante Moggallana also know, and he should be able to just say, I can guarantee that as well, right, Bhante?
Yeah. I don't need to guarantee it. He would have said like,
yes. Or I can guarantee that you are a sotapanna, right, there, right, Bhante?
So and you first not ask the question, I think.
Yes, Bhante. So the first argument seems more convincing, right, Bhante?
Mm-hmm.
The old commentary.
Is not convincing, you mean?
I mean among these two way of explanation, the first explanation is more convincing, right, Bhante? Yeah. The explanation from old commentary.
Yeah, I feel it's more convincing.
Okay, Bhante. Thank you very much, Bhante.
Okay, sorry.
Sadhu, sadhu.
Yeah, so you already presented my question, Bhante. So my question was like if he's a sotapanna, then why did he ask for assurance?
Right.
Right. Yeah, because we know that there are many, many stories in the literature saying that, you know, a person who is very poor and went to see the Buddha, listened to the Dhamma, became a sotapanna, and then the Sakka or the Mara appeared and then said, okay, if you say the other way, then I'm going to make you rich and so on. But it's that, no, it's not going to happen. And then the Mara or the Sakka went to the Buddha and, you know, presented that incident. And the Buddha said that, yeah, even 1,000 Sakka or 1,000 Mara is not going to change that mindset of that person, because he has complete faith in the Triple Gem. So, I mean, according to that, we know that that noble person is not going to change the faith. And in this case, if this person is a noble person, then he's not going to ask for assurance, right?
Yeah, he will not going to ask for sure.
Yeah.
True. Yeah. So,
So here, when the Upasaka said, Boga and the Jivida, like this type. So here, what does mean the Jivida refers here?
It's life, right?
I mean, here the life is refers lifespan or the is something like the next life or something like that.
I think just take it as conventional usage. I feel life. Am I going to live? Am I not going to die? Something like that. Not lifespan. Maybe it can be referred to lifespan. Yeah, it's a good argument. Like it can refer to the lifespan. And what do you think when we say life? What does it mean by life? Life is.
I think normally when we say we wish someone like live a long life, or the life without like illness or something like that.
Lifespan.
So, yeah.
So normally when we say jivita, we have, according to the tradition, jivitanti. We have like jivitindriya, rupa. There are a few explanations. We can also say the continuation of nama rupa without any cutting off, or if it can refer to lifespan even. Yeah, I think what he was thinking, dvisu bhoganancha jivitasacha anupaddava. There is no harm, danger for your life. It means your nama, continuation of your nama and rupa. Or the jivitindriya rupa in ultimate sense.
Okay, that means that he would die with like a later state, not is by like a breaking gamma or something like that, destroying gamma.
Within the 7 days, cannot. Within the 7 days, no.
Okay. Thank you, Bandit.
Okay, so shall we call it a day? It's already 11:10 PM.
Oh, yes, Bandit. Sorry.
I think we finished the Supa Sutta. So next week we are going to do Badhya Sutta. I think I have already given the vocabulary. You can look into this. Visakha Sutta we already did. Now we have Badhya Sutta. It's not that long, that much long, but it's also very nice Sutta. So please prepare for that. I have given some assistance, not much difficult, and also the commentary. If someone could please box this, I think this. Uttama can do it, like if possible. I think she sent me a link, but I'm not sure how to do it. If someone can box this, like the commentary part will be very nice. Okay, so thank you very much for your participation and all of this.
Okay, thank you very so much, Bante.
Thank you so much, Bante.
Sadhu.
Thank you, Bante.
Thank you.